Linktree is a project that involves six partners, two from Spain, two from France, one from Germany, and one from Sweden. And in this area, there is a lot of problem with dying trees because of climate change. Right now, we are in a site where Abies alba, the silver fir, European silver fir, is dying quite a lot, actually, but also at the same time regenerating. So we feel that there is potential for adaptation in this place, as there is in other places in Europe. The aim of Linktree is to study local adaptation from the genes to the ecosystems. Tree populations have two options under climate change. They can either migrate on the one hand or adapt on the other hand. Migration will be very difficult, so we expect that adaptation will play a strong role in the future of tree populations in Europe.
Donc je viens d'effectuer un carottage. Donc cette carotte va partir au laboratoire à Avignon. Et ensuite, après analyse, on pourra déterminer la réaction de l'arbre par rapport au changement climatique actuel.
J'interviens dans le projet Linktree au niveau de la partie biologie moléculaire, génotypage et séquençage afin de mettre en évidence soit des liens de parenté entre individus récoltés sur le terrain par Norbert, soit du polymorphisme dans des gènes d'intérêt qui sont en l'occurrence les gènes de résistance à la sécheresse.
Here in Mont Ventoux, 150 years ago, there were no trees. So the trees you can see now come from the combination of human management, man has replanted trees, and natural recolonization and adaptation to local conditions. So by combining human impact or human management and natural processes, biodiversity can actually increase.
Donc je vais le compter. Donc il a 3 ans celui-là.
D'accord, donc je peux le géoréférencer.
Tu peux le prendre, oui.
Le numéro, c'est le N2.
N2.
S.
S.
227.
227. Géoréférencement effectué, c'est bon.
Allez, au suivant.
From the genes we will discover in the project, we will go from the lab to the field and study how those genes react in nature. Are they variable or not? Are they variable locally or do they vary from site to site? Once we know this, we can actually address a question posed by policymakers or managers, such as, are our forests sustainable? Can they sustain climate change? Will they be able to survive when climate change or not?
Donc d'après les analyses que nous obtenons, en fait, on essaie de voir s'il y a un effet de sélection du réchauffement climatique sur certains gènes de résistance à la sécheresse. Et les données que nous obtenons sont ensuite utilisées pour alimenter ces modèles.
We calibrated the mechanisms with all the demographic and genetics measures made since the beginning. Thanks to such results, we are now able to simulate catastrophic events like storms or very dry summer to simulate the evolution of forests during 100 or 200 years.
Our project will provide new tools and a better understanding of scientific basis of adaptation, which in turn will be useful for managers and policymakers for managing forests across Europe in a better way under climate change.